Hi, I'm Chris Danos, Sheriff of Pima County. I'm standing in front of the Pima County Adult Detention Complex, a facility that houses over 2,000 inmates and staffed by 700 of Tucson's finest employees you'll find anywhere. This facility has the capabilities of providing full medical care to all individuals inside, as well as mental health, substance abuse, GED, and religious programs. We offer these programs to both juvenile and adult offenders. We at the Pima County Sheriff's Department understand and know all too well just how difficult it is to have a loved one incarcerated. But I can assure you, everyone is treated with the same level of dignity and respect that you would be afforded if we were inside your own home. For more information to help you navigate through this difficult time, please look up our website, www.pimasheriff.org. Thank you.
Welcome to this introduction to visitations at the Pima County Jail and an overview of the services available to visitors. The main doors lead you to the waiting area and the front desk where the staff can answer your questions. This video will show you the way to register for and schedule visits, discuss some of the rules during visitations, and then highlight some of the additional services available, including posting bonds, adding money to an inmate's cash account, and providing other services. Before visitations can even be scheduled, each visitor must register in the jail's system. This can be done at one of the kiosks in the jail lobby, or it can be done over the internet. Either way, you will need to enter basic information about each expected visitor and provide one of these approved photo IDs for each adult. The easiest ID will be an official State of Arizona driver's license or ID card. Because if you swipe one of those in this kiosk, it will automatically enter much of the information you need into the computer. Children under 18 will still need to be registered, but you will only need to provide their names and birth dates. Two last steps to complete registration. First, at the end of your registration session, each person will get assigned a registration ID number. Write this down and keep it safe. It identifies you in the system and you will need it. Last step, you must bring that photo ID you used to register with down to our front desk the first time you want to visit so our staff can verify your information. Now you're ready to schedule your visit. Some things to remember. One free visit a week. Visits must be scheduled at least one day in advance, either online or here at the jail at this kiosk, so we can make arrangements for inmates to be available. A maximum of 4 people per visit, and there are the other standard rules. When you arrive for your visit, check in at the front desk. They will make sure you're all set. When the visit starts, the staff will announce it, and you will bring your group to the left side of the front desk to get to your assigned booth. Then there are some additional details that will make your visits better. Be on time. When your 30-minute visit is scheduled to start, it will start, whether you're here or not. So be on time, or better, early. There are also a number of other services available here at the jail, some available 24 hours a day. Many of these other services are located just east of the waiting area. In this area, there are a variety of other services available. This is the inmate accounts area, also known as the cash window, which is open 7 days a week, except on county holidays. Payments can be made here using cash, cashier's check, U.S. government check, or money order. Additional paid internet-based inmate visits are now available and can be paid for when scheduling your visit, either online or at the kiosks. A reminder that these visits, like all public visits, are monitored and recorded, and inappropriate behavior can result in revocation of visitation privileges. There are some other questions that visitors often have. If you want to know who's here at the jail, there are three ways. Ask at the front desk. Call the information line at 351-8111 or check the inmate lookup on our website, pimasheriff.org. The property area and the inmate release area are just east of the main entrance. The property area is where inmates or their representatives can retrieve an individual's property when it has been released. The release area is where inmates who are leaving the jail will exit. Remember, the release process can take up to 4 or 5 hours for processing to be completed. Video court is held at the minimum security facility, which is just around the corner from the main jail at 1801 South Mission Road. Although inmates are present only by audio video from the main jail, you can see the live proceedings in the video courtroom, which is scheduled twice a day at 9 a.m. and 8 p.m. We hope you've found the information here useful. If you still have questions, please ask us.